In order to solve this problem, you need to have a good understanding of what the original function proc does. So let's take the two cases that really embody the output of this function. There are two inputs, but the output only depends on the value of A, specifically the value of the function test on A. If test A is true, then we return the second parameter, B. If test A is false, we return the first parameter, A. That's what we need to check in each of these functions. So let's start looking at them. In proc 1, if test X, which is the first parameter, is true, we return Y. This matches with the original function. If test of the first parameter is true, we return the second, as we do in proc 1. If test of the first parameter is false, we return that parameter, X. So test X is false, which is equivalent to test A is false, and in both cases, we return A and X, which are just different names for the same variable in this function. So this is equivalent. Let's look at the second function, proc 2. Notice here that this condition is based on the value of B. We know this can't possibly be equivalent to proc, our original function, because the output here is not dependent on the value of B. So we can tell right away that this is false. This is not equivalent to our original function. Let's look at proc 3. The structure here is a little different, but let's work our way through it by going through both of the examples. In the event that test A is true, we set result to B and we return result. So as our original function did, if test A is true, we return B. If test A is false, we simply return result, which was set at the beginning to A. So the overall functionality is that if test A is true, we return A. This matches with original function definition. So this is equivalent to proc. Now we have the last function, proc 4. It might throw you off that you see udacity in quotes here, which is not present in any other function, but it's important we work our way through the problem. If test A is true, then not test A is false. So we return B. So if test A is true, we return B. That matches with the original definition. If test A is false, not test A is true, so we set B to udacity, but then we return A. If test A is false, we change the value of B, but we don't do anything with it. We just return A. So the result is the same as our original function proc.